tiara encrusted with carnelians? This is about as ritzy as you can get.
So shiny.
Thank you. Isn't this...
Oh, this is where they published the Imperial Chronicle newspaper.
Thank you.
Oh my.
Lady Clotilde, is it time for you to depart?
Yes, I'll be stepping out for a while. But more importantly, who do we have here?
Is that... No way!
Vita Clotilde?
Whoa! I can't believe it! It's really her!
I never thought I'd actually get the chance to meet her.
Wait, who is this now?
You three! Don't just stand there staring! You're in the presence of the legendary opera singer Vita Clotilde! The Azure Diva herself!
The Azure Diva, huh? I do recall hearing that name at some point.
Wait, you don't know who she is?
I'm not surprised. Opera is a world unto itself. I expect there are multitudes who have never heard of me before. I'm Vita Clotilde, an opera singer. I'd be delighted if you would come and hear me sing sometime.
Thank you.
Oh, what a nice looking treasure chest.
Let's buy treasure.
Oh, what a nice looking treasure chest.
Okay.
This would make a great training area. I envy the people who live around here.
Only you would see an underground passage and think about training.
Treasure chest!
What a nice looking treasure chest.
We have nothing to fear.
My turn. All right, let's do this.
Understood. Yeah. My turn. Fought well, Ellie.
It's all I can do to keep up with you.
Be careful!
Here we go! All right! right, let's do this!
Got it!
I'll handle it.
Of course! Behold, my most powerful strike! Radiant Breakdown!
Right! Keep it up, everyone!
My turn! There! Now's our chance! Elliot!
Okay!
Okay.
Go! Now's our chance!
I'll take you up! Okay, that was tough.
Nice work, though.
Well, that was... You know, maybe you should just stop worrying about trying to form a combat link with each other.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I can see why you'd really want to.
No. I don't want to hold our group back more than I already have. I'd like to withdraw from active combat and take a more supporting role for the duration of this field study.
But Laura, it doesn't make any sense for you not to be in the thick of the fight.
Don't be ridiculous. If anyone should be benched, it's me. It makes sense when you consider what each of us brings to a fight.
No. My own immaturity is the cause of this. There's still a part of me that refuses to accept you, and this is the result. I'm sorry. I didn't think I was this narrow-minded. And I apologize for the distress my prejudice has no doubt been causing. I came to realize during my club activities that I still have a lot of maturing left to do.
Laura.
As such, Rean, I wish to withdraw.
Denied. Actually, I'll be the one withdrawing from frontline combat.
What?
Huh?
Rean?
This seems awfully sudden. What's your line of thinking?
During all the battles we fought, one thing stood out to me. I couldn't help but notice that under ordinary circumstances, Laura and Fee's fighting styles complement each other perfectly.
Well,
you think so?
Interesting. What do you mean?
Laura's the ideal knight, standing strong in the thick of the fight, dominating enemies with her blade. Then there's Fee, the ideal vanguard, overwhelming the opposition with her speed and creating openings for Laura. During the practical exam, none of us should have stood a chance against the two of you.
Put it that way, it does make sense.
If they could form a combat link, they'd be virtually unstoppable.
Yeah, don't think that's escaped you two either. That's why you keep trying to form a combat link, but there's something stopping you from connecting with each other. Whatever it is, it's been frustrating both of you this whole time, right?
Mm-hmm. It's exactly as you say.
Okay, so, since that's how things stand, it makes no sense for you two to just give up and withdraw from combat. In fact, considering everyone's relative strengths and weaknesses, it makes the most sense for me to fall back. This way, you'll have more chances to work out whatever it is that's standing in the way of you forming a link.
You have my thanks.
We'll take you up on your offer then.
That's what I like to hear.
You really can be audacious sometimes, you know.
Just like you were with me and Eustace.
You think? I don't really think I did anything out of the ordinary.
You, Rean, to not think anything of it. Still, thanks to you, there might be hope for these two after all.
We'll do what we can.
But first, we need to get back to the hotel, right?
Leave it to me!
Right!
Okay.
Is that a treasure chest?
There's a light.
The sound's getting louder, too.
We must be getting close to the exit now. Ooh, this looks like a good spot. This is incredible.
He could open a shop with all the instruments here.
A piano, violins, wind instruments, a robust percussion section. I'm assuming the papers in the cabinet are all sheet music.
There's no way you can call this just a hobby.
Yeah, coming in here, this must look like some rabid obsession to you guys. You know, my mom was a pretty famous pianist. Being raised around music like that, my sister and I ended up sharing her love of music.
Really?
Looking at all this, I can see why you decided to join the wind orchestra at the academy.
Still, why didn't you go to the same school as the people we met earlier?
Fee?
Wait, Fee, that's not...
Don't worry about it. I'm sure this comes as no surprise. But I'd originally planned to attend the music academy.
Oh.
My sister and I grew up listening to our mom play the piano. Dad was more the strong, stoic type. He didn't know much about music, but he was head over heels in love with her. Our home was always filled with the sound of music, and it kept our family smiling together. But 7 years ago, Mom got really ill. Eventually, she passed away. After her death, my sister and I both wanted to follow in her footsteps. She enrolled at the music academy and began working toward a career as a pianist. Naturally, I tried to do the same. But Dad wouldn't hear of it. It's one thing to have it as a hobby, but the idea of a man of the Empire making his living through music is absurd. No matter how hard I tried to convince him, he just shook his head and refused to listen. Then he started recommending one military academy after another, trying to push me toward a career in the army. Eventually, I didn't have much choice. I had to give up my dream of attending the music academy. I hated him for it. I really did. I'm no good at fighting, never have been. I'd get smoked in a real war. But after some research, I found one academy, Thors, offered plenty of music-related classes. And that about half of its graduates end up in careers outside the military. In the end, I met him halfway and chose to enroll at Thor's. Kinda pathetic, huh? You've all got great reasons why you're there at the academy. Then there's me, who'd rather be on a stage than a battlefield, but I couldn't go against my dad. For a while, I started to think that maybe my passion for music had kinda cooled off. But I'm still full of regrets about the music academy and the summer festival concert, so I guess it hasn't after all. Oh, I wish I could just crawl into a hole right now.
So that's how you ended up at Thor's.
I had no idea.
Do you regret it? Coming to Thor's and all?
Huh? Of course not. Why would I?
Huh?
So you don't?
Life at the academy keeps me busy, but I still have time to perform with the wind orchestra after class is out. And I feel like I really broaden my horizons every time we go on a field study. Honestly, I feel like I get more out of Thor's than if I had just enrolled at the music academy without much thought. Maybe it's because whether I decide I want to be a musician or do something else totally different, I'll at least have the chance to choose what I want without someone deciding for me.
Elliot.
Wow, you've really given this a lot of thought.
You really are strong, Elliot.
I wish I thought so too. I still feel jealous when I see my friends who went to the music academy putting their heart and soul into their music. But even with that, I've got no regrets about coming to Thor's. None at all. Besides, if I hadn't come, I never would have met you guys, would I? I'd regret that way more.
How can you say that with a straight face?
Maybe he's just oblivious.
I didn't think I was saying anything particularly embarrassing.
I figured that most people would blush saying something like that.
Still, this is Elliot we're talking about. He can get away with it.
You're the last person who should be saying that, Rean. Actually, I just remembered. I guess I do have one regret after all.
Oh? What is it?
Remember the summer festival concert my friend said they're going to be performing in? Back when my mom was still alive, she performed in it, and my sister played in it 5 years ago, too. So I was really hoping that I'd be able to take the stage there one day, too.